Hey, welcome back. This is part two in the video instruction on how to get EPUB files onto your Kindle. Now, in the step one, we set up a folder called eBooks and downloaded some EPUBs that we bought into that folder. Step two, we're going to download an awesome piece of software. And I don't know how to pronounce this. Is it Calibre? Is it Calibre? Is it, I don't know. Let's just download, I'm going to call it Calibre. And I have Windows, so I'm going to use the Windows download. Okay, then after the download completes, click down here and click Run. Accept the terms, install. When the install finishes, the box is checked to launch, click Finish. At this point, we can close the browser, click on Calibre, here's my language, choose a location for your books, click Next, and then I get to choose what type of a device I have. Well, I have an Amazon Kindle Fire, click Next. That's all it is. Great demo videos here, great user manual. But I can show you how to do it. Okay, so here we are in Calibre. They have a quick start guide, but I want to add my books. So add books, and we'll browse to C:\ ebooks, and I'll choose all of these books. Click open. Takes a little bit of time for each book. The beautiful thing about EPUBs is the cover and metadata is built right in so that you now know the title instead of just the ISBN. I can click on each book and see the cover. I can also search by author or by tag. The tags are usually identified by the publisher. Okay, next up, it's time to connect the Kindle. Find that cable that came with the Kindle, hook the micro USB in the bottom of the Kindle, other end of the USB into the USB port on your computer, and give it a moment for the computer to recognize the Kindle. My Kindle says I'm now in USB mode, and the AutoPlay appears, which tells me that the computer now knows that the Kindle is attached. I can dismiss this though. Choose an item, right click, send to device, and I'm going to send to main memory. Auto-convert the following books? Yes. In the lower right-hand corner, you can see that the job is processing. You don't have to wait for that to finish. You can choose the next book. I really don't need to see this confirmation each time, so we'll click yes. And now there are two jobs processing. We'll continue. As individual jobs finish, you'll see it appear in as a check mark in on device. Now in this case, Celtic Knight was a much smaller book, less photos, than the Learn Excel book, so it finished first. If it seems like it's taking a long time, click on the jobs icon and you'll see how many minutes are remaining. Ah, there we go, everything's done. Now before we leave Calibre, let me just show you a couple cool things. Down here in the bottom, we can turn off the tags pane and then click the next icon to bring up something that is very reminiscent of the view in iTunes. All right, so this is just a beautiful, beautiful piece of software. From Calibre. When you start Calibre, there's a little heart icon out there. Click that heart icon and you can donate to the software author. Again, with these open source projects, the author is usually very responsive to requests, and so it's a great little view. Okay, so all of our books are on the Kindle. Let's take a look. Here, I want to disconnect on the Kindle. And if you're not in books, go into books. We'll scroll down and our new books are right here. Take a look.
flip through. Hyperlinks will work. The images will be there. Looks good, just like in a regular book.
All right, so there you have it. We took a look at how to download and set up Calibre and use Calibre to manage all of your ebooks and get them direct to your device, whether it's a Kindle or any other device. Again, I want to thank you for taking the time and for your support of independent publishers. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel.